All right, everyone, welcome. Welcome. First off, a little seating. We know sometimes maybe you think we need to sit in the back, but we would love to see your shiny faces. If you guys would like to move forward, that would be fantastic. If not, you understand. You're welcome to stay where you're seated. We are here for our hello fifth grade promotion ceremony. Woo! We made it. Cool pandemic. Welcome to our fifth grade ceremony. We have a great agenda planned for you today. We will walk you through to make sure we are socially distanced. So let me just talk about that real quick. Number one, please make sure your masks stay on during the entire ceremony today, as well as we are keeping our distance between one another. Of course, families encourage you to stay together. But we will walk through the procedures in terms of how we make sure we move around to follow all safety protocols here for today. I also want to give it up for a special group that has put this together. Let's give it up for the staff that has put together our beautiful ceremony today. And scholars, kids, you can give it up for your parents that are here that have supported you on this journey. Let's give it up for your family members that are here with you today. I am Bryce Johnson, the principal here at Pyle Elementary School. You're going to hear about a name change in just a second, but you guys are the last graduating class of Pyle Elementary School. The last graduating class of Pyle Elementary School. We will be very peak, effective July 1. And so we will, Mr. Strickland is stealing your thunder a little bit. But we will do the one final treat here in just a second. Before we get to that, I have a few words. Congratulations on getting to this point. You have gone to school approximately 1,992 days. That's a lot, regardless of the weather. You wrote many paragraphs, you read a lot of books, you took a bunch of tests, a bunch of SOLs. You learned some math facts, I hear some guesses out there. You ate over 300 pieces of pizza and drank enough milk to feed plenty of people. You guys had so much milk and so much pizza, it is ridiculous. You attended several field trips. You got your dance on, doing some moves that I could not do. Mr. Lee and I had to stop you from doing some moves occasionally from time to time. You pushed your parents to lose their hair over all the work and helping you at home. You ate, this is one for the books. You ate an incredible amount of, and I'm not sure I understand why, Takis and spicy Doritos. I see some head shaking over there. Okay, you built lasting friendships. You survived a pandemic, and you learned that the word Zoom doesn't necessarily mean just to move and run to a place. It actually is a thing. We learned to Zoom online this year. Amazing. You challenge each other. You mature, you build a special two-year bond with three amazing educators. Let's give it up for Ms. Jackson, Mr. Whitlock, and Ms. Godfrey. Amazing. Today, myself, Ms. Anita, countlessly, we're excited about where you're headed. You're very, have great potential. And so we are excited to say you embody the hashtag talented hikers. Let's give it up for the fifth grade class to celebrate today. I challenge you to grow this list of accomplishments, to continue to push yourself. Our school's vision is to strive to inspire a passion for learning. You may wonder why I have these letters on my mat. It stands for strive to inspire a passion for learning. We want passionate learners. We want scholars that are ready to go out in the world, be productive, but challenge themselves. It's important to realize that you have goals. My mom would always look at me and say, she'd look at me and be like, why are you so lazy sometimes? She'd look at me and just tell me that, straight up. And you guys would have that conversation with your child. So when we would have this chat, she would also give me a phrase that would go something like this. She'd say, son, you are not gonna be 30 years old sitting on my couch eating potato chips. It is not going to happen. Hear me. And I see some people waving fingers and shaking heads out there in the crowd. It's a reality. And so even now, if you are looking at middle school and you're coming out of fifth grade, you need to start thinking long term. What am I going to do to be a productive member of society? Because you all can and will be that productive member. So I challenge you in regards to that. Justin Timberlake, the great philosopher, he put it well. He said, you're not meant to do what's easy. You're meant to challenge yourself. Listen to JT. Listen to what he has. Today in our society, we need more scholars, more model citizens, students that are excited about learning. Take advantage of your time, especially in middle school and high school. Please challenge yourself as you move through these parts and get to the next journey. It is difficult to look past today, tomorrow, but I challenge you to have true vision, to not only see things that are, but what they can be. Helen Keller highlighted this by saying, I would much prefer to be blind than to be without vision. I may not be able to see what is, but I can see what is possible. You need to think about that. Think about what I'm looking ahead towards. Talk to your parents about that. Go towards your next educational setting. Whatever middle school that is, you are always welcome back here at Troward Elementary School. Never settle. We cannot wait to see where you'll be in the next 5, 10 years. We're looking forward to that journey. Again, you will always be a Tiger and you're always welcome back. We appreciate your time. Let's go Tigers. Here we go. All right. So with that said, we're going to transition now. I kind of gave it away, but to Mr. Strickland, our amazing art teacher, please, Mr. Strickland.
When I first came here many, many years ago, we had a PE teacher, Mr. Yule, who's a PE teacher over at Langley right now, and he wrote for us, quite the poet, he wrote for us, we call it John Tyler Freeman, for all these years we've been saying it on the morning announcements. And so if you guys have been here since kindergarten or first grade or second grade, you probably know. So if I can get everybody to stand real quick, we'll say it together. If you don't know it, I know the staff does, I know many of the scholars do. All right, it starts off. Tyler
Tigers are the best. We're tails and whiskers above the rest. We work hard in every way. We earn our stripes every day. Spend a day with us and you'll agree, a Tyler Tiger is a thing to be. And whether you realized it or not yet, you are the last of the Tyler Tigers, because next year we will have a new mascot. So you are the end of an era. All right, let's hear it for the John Tyler Tigers. And I'm going to hand it over to Miss Belches.
I am Miss Belcher, school counselor here at Tyler. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Good, good, good. Congratulations, my friends. I'm so proud of you. I'm so happy for you. We made it, or you made it. We made it through the year of the math. Well, I guess we did. We're still wearing them, huh? But we made it. We made it through social distancing. We're still doing that, too. But at least we're here. We're in person. We made it through not being able to see our friends and family. We got pretty far. We're almost there. But look at you now. Zooming into middle school, right?
Yes.
Right? We're zooming into middle school. Are you excited? I'm excited. I'm excited. You're zooming into middle school. All right, all right. Look at my teachers and look at my staff over there. Okay, so now we know middle school is a little different from elementary, right? So we're going to have many classes instead of our few classes we have here in elementary. It's a lot of different things going on. So I don't want to frighten you, but I want you to be ready. So when you get to middle school, I want you to get to know your counselor, because that's what we're there for. You're going to meet many new friends. I want you to get out there, meet your new friends, have a good time, but I want you to choose your friends wisely. I want you to make sure you ask all the questions you need to ask, because there's a lot going on in middle school. Ask questions. What you don't know, ask. But I want you to get out there. This is a time of transition, a time of growth. It's going to be a good time. It's a new beginning for you all, okay? It's a new chapter in your life. So get out there, ask questions. I want you to join clubs. You have an opportunity. When you get to middle school, there's a lot of new stuff out there. Join some of the clubs that's in middle school. Get to know what your school has to offer. There's some good stuff out there. Let's see, what else you got going on? I can't even think right now. I just want you to get out there, have a good time, choose your friends. Don't get into any of the mess that's out there, any of the drama that's in your school. I'm so proud of you. This year has been so challenging. Family, you did it. You stuck by your kids. This has been difficult for them, for you. You showed up. You got them to where they are today. You did it. This has been difficult. Good job. Congratulations. I'm so sorry. The one, the only, Miss Onita, our assistant principal. Good morning, everyone.
Oh, I know you guys can do better than that. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right, this is a great day to be here in Tigerland to the class of 2021. You have proven yourselves this year more than ever. You have worked to complete your K-5 school careers, all while in a pandemic. You have witnessed much during this year here in this particular country, and you have been flexible, you have been gracious as we went through the ups and downs of virtual learning. During this short time that I've been here, because as you know, I just had a baby, so I feel like I haven't really been here, I have learned so much from all of you, and some of you I've known since you were in, I want to say, second, third grade. Some friends came with me from other schools that I've taught at. And so I just want you to know that you have triumphed over one of the biggest challenges that we have faced in our world, right? And you all have succeeded. Never, never, never forget that. So when you are faced with a challenge, whether it's in sixth grade, seventh grade, high school, or just in life when you're all grown up, make sure that you do not forget what you were able to achieve in fifth grade. Tap into that, because if you do, you can do anything that you set your mind to. We are proud of you and all of your hard work that you have done here at Tyler. Dream big. And know that you can do anything and be anything that you choose as long as you work hard. And know that we are super, super proud of each and every one of you. Thank you to the families. Thank you to the teachers. Thank you to all the staff here, because we cannot do this work alone. And we wish you nothing but success in the future. Have a great summer. So that's the end of my little speech. And now we are going to turn it over to our amazing fifth grade team. They are going to distribute. Say that again?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. They are going to distribute certificates. Hopefully I'll say the next few things correctly. If not, Dr. Johnson will call me out, I'm sure. When your name is called, you're going to come up to the front down the aisle with your family. The scholar is going to take a photo with the certificate, with the staff. And then from there, families, you can take a photo with your child as well. And then from there, please proceed over to the right-hand side, well, my right-hand side, to get your swag bag. A lot of cool things in there. And then you can return back to your seats. And then we will take on from there. All right, so I'm going to turn it over to the fifth grade team.
Good morning, everyone. I'm so glad to see each and every one of you here, those of you that are coming out. So we are ready to begin. First name is Tiana Falk. Next up, we have Louis Favada II. Next, we have Cameron Freeman. Next, Adon Griffith. Jordan Hargrove.
Good job.
Next, we have Michaela Harkins. Legend Hawkins, Washington. Anaya Johnson. We now have Denalia Johnson. Next up, we have Amaya Joyner. Woo! Trinity Lynn. Trinity couldn't be here, but she's watching via live stream. Ms. Jackson's gonna stand and accept her award. She's gonna be proud, Trinity.
All right.
Next, we have Aledra Lothar. Damia Malcolm. Ariana Malone. Anna Olsen. Chloe Parker.
Imani Pikett. And last but not least, Imante Pikett. Okay, so Ms. Jackson here, it's just been, a crazy year. It's been great that you've, allowed us to work with your babies. You know, that's our team, we looped, so we taught a lot of your children in fourth grade and this year in fifth grade. So they've really endured a lot. It's been very challenging, but we've given them the tools and they're ready for middle school. So good luck to all of you. Oh, let me say it loud. All right, guys. I hope you go forth in middle school and that you do great things. Make lots of friends, have fun, but most of all, most importantly, study hard.
It's been great to work with you and to see you grow so much. We've been through ups and downs of the COVID thing and we did it together. And it's just so neat to be able to celebrate this and remember. We're here for you anytime. You can call and if you need anything, let us know. And that I know that that the resource team feels the same way too. We are here for you, and we thank you so much for getting to know you and your family so much. One announcement: we have. I know you all moving on, but we have a member of our fifth grade team kind of moving on to teaching language arts as her focus subject in another Hampton school. And we have to say goodbye to Miss Godfrey. And we have worked as a team together for several years now. And it's been wonderful. It's been great to when you work and you love each other and you're working and looking out for each other. That's special. When you come across that, you want to stay. But she's moving on. And so we wanted to say goodbye to Canada. And we have some flowers for a surprise. Flowers.
Please say something.
Say something.
I'll take this so you don't break.
Thank you guys. It's been great here at Tyler's, and I hope to see you all. Email me, call me, text me. I'll be keeping up with you guys. So have a good summer.
One more time, round of applause for all the staff, as well as all the families that are here. Thank you guys for doing a wonderful job getting to this point. This concludes our service, our ceremony. You're welcome to come take a picture up front if you'd like as a family. Please, again, make sure you maintain social distance space between each other. And we will be needing to clean the chairs as well pretty soon for our next round. So at this point, this concludes our ceremony. Again, thank you guys for all that you've done to make this journey such a success.